So I'm here with Mr. Mark Watson, the new principal of Patuxent High School. And you were here last year for a short period of time, correct?
Yes.
So some of the students know you.
Yes.
Those, like, our freshmen, they're new. They don't know who you are. So coming here, you want to make an impact. What impact do you want to have on the newer students that don't know who you are?
I just want to have a positive impact, obviously, on staff and students. I think it's really important to me that my actions kind of show everybody what I'm all about, and what I'm all about is being a resource to everyone. Help you out any way that I can, whether it be academically, you need to talk with someone, talking about future plans or struggling in a class or something about sports or something about, fine arts. I just want to be here to support everyone, and I just want to make sure that everyone comes here and they feel like they want to be here, they feel safe, they feel supported, and that they look forward to coming to school every day. Because I know that I look forward to coming to school every day, because every day is new, every day is great, and I'm excited every day that I get here, and I want that to kind of be the vibe that we get from students as well.
Okay, so how did being here last year influence your decision to come here full time?
Well, for me, I feel very fortunate, because I kind of feel like I hit the ground running this summer, because I was here for 3 months, obviously, as you stated. So I knew people, I knew some of the students, how things work. We didn't make a lot of sweeping changes, because simply they didn't need to be made. So when you're new, it's important that you come in and that you observe and you listen and you kind of soak everything in before you kind of figure out if you want to make any changes. But for me, I think it being here last year just set me up for the potential to have a lot of success.
And what policies or new, like, ideas have you put in place to kind of push that Pax Familia vibe to go back to our roots?
Well, I think that the SBI initiative, Student Voice Initiative, is a big thing. I think that I'm a big person on communication. I still believe in that face-to-face, that sit-down talk, not through the phone, not through social media. To me, I'm a face-to-face person, so I just have this belief that through conversation we can really understand each other and work things out when we have differences. Also understand that we see things from different lenses. But at the same time, our students came to us in the summer and said, this is what we want to do. And when you have students that feel empowered to be leaders, we're going to run with that. And, there's students here that lead every day, and we want to continue to, support that and encourage that. And so really, for me, I didn't necessarily come in here and create or, change or do anything. This is like student-led, staff, student and staff-led, where they feel like this change needed to happen. And I'm definitely going to support it, because I think what we've seen so far, it's been really, really good.
Mm-hmm. And kind of straying off a little bit more into, like, the funner realm of school, we do a lot of events here at Patuxent High School. We have our family meetings, our pep rallies, sports events. What event in the year are you most looking forward to?
I like homecoming week, spirit week, whatever it's called. Everyone gets to kind of just kind of let loose a little bit, but not too much, because we still have to learn.
Yeah.
We still have tests, still have things going on. But at the same time, you should be able to come to school and enjoy it, have fun. It's serious, but it can't be too serious. And that's kind of how I am. Like, I take my job very seriously, but at the same time, I want to come here every day and have fun too, just like you guys. Like, I want to have fun with working with students and working with staff. And so for me, like, that week is always an enjoyable week. So I'm really looking forward to how Patuxent High School does.
Last question. So, like, besides school, you're here a lot. Mm-hmm. What other hobbies do you take on outside of school?
My son is 9 years old. He plays tackle football. I used to be the head football coach at Calvert High School for 6 years, a long time ago. So that kind of gets me back into my coaching roots, which I really enjoy. It's different coaching, 7, 8, 9-year-old kids as opposed to, teenagers. But at the same time, I spend a lot of time with my family and my kids. Really, they're very sports oriented. Soccer, football. My daughter cheers, and she plays flag football as well as my son. So my kids are into sports, and as you get older, you start to like what your kids like, because you love your kids. So whatever they're doing, you're kind of all about it. So,
Mr. Mark Watson, the family man, thank you for taking time out of your busy day. I know you got a lot of stuff. It's a busy morning.
I know I always come and go, but it's out of my control. And you'll be left in the dust unless I stuck by you. You're the sun.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. Dude on the rock covered in all the water. Yeah, that rock's on fire. not completely on fire, but there's definitely a big one right there. That little spot is the Amazon rainforest. Due to deforestation, logging, and mining, the famous forest is ablaze. Not only is this destroying habitats of millions of creatures, but it's even helping to kill the planet faster. The carbon dioxide fumes from the fire are gathering in the atmosphere to greaten the greenhouse effect and melt the polar ice caps that are probably going to drown us all eventually. But also, the trees are burning. Trees turn carbon dioxide into oxygen. You know, the stuff we breathe. So less trees equals less carbon dioxide being turned into oxygen, and more carbon dioxide going into the atmosphere. It's a double whammy. What can we do, you ask? Well, put down your fire extinguishers and garden hoses, and take out your wallets. The best way to help is buying land to prevent logging, mining, and deforestation. But that's ridiculous. You'd have to own land in South America, and nobody has that kind of money just lying around. A more reasonable option is to vote for people that are interested in stopping the fires in South America.
The current protesting in Hong Kong has been ongoing since June of this year, and it appears it won't be dying down anytime soon. Millions flooded the street last month in protest of the government's policies. So why is this happening? While Hong Kong has a history of protesting and demonstrating the government policies, the current situation is a result of a bill being voted on that would allow for the extradition of Hong Kong citizens to mainland China for trial. The possibility has rubbed people the wrong way because it would violate their right to peacefully protest. Chinese citizens are demanding that Carrie Lam, chief executive of Hong Kong, withdraw the extradition bill. The bill gives the government the right to extradite anyone who commits a crime or does something illegal as defined in the Chinese government. Protesters have also demanded that for Carrie Lam to step down. Protesters have been arrested to be released, a separate independent investigation into police brutality, and greater democratic freedoms. 2 weeks ago, Carrie Lam agreed to terminate the extradition bill, but she refused to step down. As of September, there has been more than 2,000 injuries from police interactions and 1,453 arrests. Based on the information that has been released to the public by the Chinese state-run media, in China's history of resorting to violence to restore order, some of the protests have turned violent. Many more people are retaliating with violence against the government. I believe that this situation is only going to get worse. While we wait and watch to see if democracy pulls through or if Chinese government restores order.
My name's Noah Gill, and I'm on the hunt for someone who's as cool as me. Let's see if we can find. I'm so cool, I can jump an entire hallway. I'll bet you aren't that cool. I'm with Derek Mellon. That was 1, 2, 3, 4! I'm here with Miss Price. How far can you broad jump?
Very far.
Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. New highest. I'm so cool, I can run up a flight of stairs in 4.13 seconds. Can you go? That's a new record. Yeah, next one. 12.27 seconds. Go. A new slowest record of 27 seconds and 36 milliseconds. I can roll my tongue. Can you? Can you roll your tongue?
No.
Good try.
Can you roll your tongue?
Yes.
Can we see?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. She can do it!
Can you roll your tongue? Yes, he can. I can do a one-handed push-up. Can you?
Good try.
Yeah. Almost.
One-handed push-up, go. Perfect! I'm Noah Gale, and this has been the Coolness Challenge. I'm still the coolest.
Welcome to this week's sports recap. Football was 2-0 since we last seen you, and it's HOCO game time. Homecoming. La Plata. Let's go, football. Field hockey was 2-2 since we've last been together, and they beat Great Mills and La Plata. Volleyball, well, they were 1-0, and they got a game against McDonough. McDonough. They played it on Thursday, but I can't tell you what happened because I recorded this on Thursday morning, and I don't know what happened. Cross country continued to run really fast and kept getting better. Soccer was 2-1 in the last 2 weeks. Key wins against CHOP and a hard-fought loss against H-Town. Girls soccer kept practicing and competing. They have a game next Monday. Golf, well, they hit it. They hit it really far. And they did really well in their last match. Great job, golf. Let's get to the interviews!
Hi, I'm Nick Boswell, and I'm here with...
Nick Boswell.
Nick Boswell, how much have you liked the season so far, and why?
It's fun for me, because golf, like golf is probably one of the best sports out there right now.
What made you interested in playing golf your freshman year?
Because it's just a chill sport, and everybody else does it, obviously, so.
How's the team been doing so far?
I mean, we're pretty good, I guess.
Thank you.
I'm here with
Josiah Campbell.
Josiah Campbell is a Patuxent High School football player on the Patuxent High School football team. Josiah, what is different this year than the football team last year?
Well, last year we didn't have that much chemistry, and this year we have a lot more.
How does it feel to be one of the leaders on the team?
It feels great. I can lead my boys to a victory, catching touchdowns for them.
How do you think the season's going so far?
Well, in the beginning it was rough, but now we're like working together way more, so yeah, going good.
All right, thank you. I'm here with
Shone.
Shone, what is different about the season this year than last year?
We have a new setter, so we have to like figure out ways to work together in harmony, which we're doing pretty good at.
How do you think the season's going so far, and why?
It's going pretty good because our communication's there and our bonds are there, so it's just easier to be around each other.
What are your goals for this season?
To win states.
States. All right, I'm here with
Hope Sunshine.
Hope, how do you feel that the soccer season is going so far?
It's going pretty good. We've had some rough patches, but we managed.
It's your senior season, correct?
Yes.
How does that make you feel?
It's kind of sad, actually.
Why is that?
Because I'm never going to play again.
No more soccer. What is your goal for the season?
To beat Calvert, possibly.
Calvert. Rivals. Yeah.
She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man.
Last Tuesday, September 24th, Student Voice Initiative. What is Student Voice Initiative? Student Voice Initiative is for us as students to share our ideas to make the school better and see the changes that we want to see. Let's see what you guys had to say.
Hello, I'm here with
Kamora,
Kensley,
Emma Poteet,
Megan,
Kayla,
Elizabeth,
Colin,
Damien,
Ryan,
Justin Jackson,
Elisa,
Anaya.
So, what things did you take away from it that you liked?
Not many people were engaged in my little classroom, so I don't really know what I took away from it.
How do you think people feel or their first impression was about it?
I think some people just like didn't take it seriously, and I kind of feel like it's the same as advisory, just we have a student teacher, so.
All right, so what are your first impressions on SVI?
I kind of think it didn't help anything at all, and it was, like, not relevant to help with anything.
If there's some changes that could be made to SVI to make it more interesting, what changes would you come up with?
Probably to be with your own friends, not random people that you've never spoken to, because how are you supposed to like share information?
What was your first impression of it?
It was a little bit awkward, but it like got better throughout it.
What were some of the issues that your group talked about when explaining issues in the school?
They talked about the 15-minute mark at lunch, and they wanted teachers to be more aware that students play sports and have other classes to like, yeah.
All right, and the last question is, did you take anything away that would help you or be useful?
Well, I got to see other people's point of views on stuff, so I guess, yeah.
All right, thank you. All right, and basically, I just want to know your guys' first impression of SVI.
First impression, it was, let me speak off my voice. Like, let me get some stuff out.
It was very interesting. I mean, it was kind of quiet in my class for the first time. Not everyone was really comfortable with the idea.
So you guys didn't have really much group participation?
We somehow did. Like, I was probably the most person to talk.
I mean, they all participated. It's just they didn't have much to say.
What was some things that you guys took away from your SVI groups?
Took away.
Did you learn anything like about somebody?
More, not really. Just like some people's opinions about certain topics.
That a lot of them agree on what this school should move forward with.
What were some things that you took away from it?
I think they're trying too hard, or like they're not getting into our like how we want to talk, cause like it was pretty awkward.
It was pretty awkward.
All right. What were some changes that you and your group talked about that should be made to the school?
Standardized tests and better lunch food.
All right, thank you. All right, and basically, I want to know how was your SVI group and what did you take away from it?
All right, so my SVI group was actually pretty chill. We got to say some things that couldn't usually be said that advisory. Yes, that's what I was looking for. Other than that, it was actually pretty shy. People tended to be shy, but I think it really gave us a voice, so it's pretty chill.
What were some of the problems in the school that your group talked about that should be changed to make the school like feel more comfortable to people and safe?
So to be perfectly honest, the two biggest problems that were announced were dress code, bias behavior, and the final one was AC. So
the AC.
AC. And what was your first impression of SVI?
Pretty intimidating. I mean, it was, people were shy, so it's kind of hard to say what you wanted to say. You know what I mean?
Yes.
What was your first impression of SVI?
SVI? I didn't really like it.
What did you guys take away from it, and what was your first impression?
That like everybody's like a whole group, like everybody participates in it, and it's like a fun thing to do to like agree with everybody in the group and all have like your same like ideas and everything.
Yeah, I agree with her.
Like, did you get any feedback from your class that is useful or that you can use to help improve the school?
Nobody said nothing. We asked them their opinions and they didn't participate.
Oh, all right. Is there any changes that you can make to the SVI groups that would make students want to participate more?
We could put friends with friends, but I think they want random people so they can get to know each other.
All right, thank you. All right, I'm here with
Mr. Watson.
All right, how do you feel about SVI and what was your first impression of it?
I think my first impression of it was good. I think I'm really impressed with the student leadership in the building that want to take the initiative to try to affect positive change in the building. I'm a firm believer, and I've said this to a lot of students and staff, that
The students in the building are our greatest resource, both in numbers and with your voice and what you guys can really do to affect change. So for me, it's great. We want to see more students involved, more students taking that leadership role. And we know certainly if we certainly pay attention to things, that peer-to-peer interactions are more influential than an adult telling you what to do. So I think sometimes you guys really, get one another, obviously, from peer to peer. So we want that to continue and evolve into something bigger and better than what it is already.
Now, in a couple of the groups, we had problems with participation in some of the SVI groups. What do you think can help to improve on the participation of the SVI groups?
I think with, again, it's kind of like when a new team comes together, you know, you have to do some team building exercises and some bonding. It's just like school, the first class of the first day of school. You don't know everybody in the room. You got to get to know each other a little bit. And with that, that more time that you spend together, you get more comfortable with each other. And so I think with time, you know, that'll evolve for in some of those classes where maybe it's a little bit of an issue right now. But for some people, you know, they're not comfortable either. And, you know, you have to kind of give them some time to get into their comfort zone to where they're willing to share or be a part of it. But hopefully, you know, we get close to, you know, everybody being on board with being willing and comfortable to communicate and participate. But I think, you know, some of those things just come with time.
Absolutely. All right, thank you.
All right, thanks, guys.